Yo, what's good, everybody? Today, we've got Ariana Grande, No Tears Left to Cry music video. This shit just dropped, and I've been getting tons of requests to check this out. So, y'all ask for it, y'all gonna get it. But before we get started, I am a vocal coach. Check me out, youcansinganything.com. I teach singing lessons online every single day through Skype. Also, in the description of this video are links to my Patreon and to my vlog channel. On my Patreon, I have a reward where I will review your singing in a video very, very similar to this one. Check it out. All that being said, here we go. Ariana Grande, No Tears Left to Cry. Look, before we get started here, I just gotta say this. A lot of vocal coaches give Ariana Grande for her vocals. I honestly don't understand it. I think that she is an amazing singer. I think that her vocals are some of the best in the industry today. I think that she's done a lot for pop music with her voice and her talent and her music. I'm kind of excited to check this out. I want to see what direction she's going to go, because a lot of pop singers today are doing some rather interesting stuff with their music videos, like Taylor Swift, for example. So I'm interested to see what Ariana Grande is going to do here. Okay. I'm digging the vibe so far. This is actually interesting. Okay. Who's she, blonde? So I'm picking it up, picking it up. I'm living, I'm living, I'm picking it up, I'm picking it up, picking it up. Oh. This isn't bad at all. This is very unique to me. I started this video off talking about how I wasn't sure what she was gonna do to respond to some of the newest pop music that's been coming out from artists like Taylor Swift, artists like Katy Perry, because pop music is kind of going in a weirder direction lately. I don't know if y'all have noticed this. And so I was curious what Ariana Grande would do, and this is a great response because she incorporates a lot of, like, it feels like almost some trap elements, which are trendy today, but also a little bit overdone, but she incorporates that with some, like, a little bit of upbeatness and a little bit of, like, funk and groove. Like, I'm into this song. It almost has some retro vibes to it, and I love that sound. And oh my god, the music video is just so modern. And it's weird in its own way. It's really cool. Retro and modern at the same time. I love how artists are doing that today. The Weeknd kind of comes to mind as an example of someone who does that. You know what also is very retro here? This beat right here. Do you hear this beat? That's a very, very retro beat. That's like the most retro beat that you could possibly have in a track. Woo! This shot here. Anyway, thank you for recommending this video. I was super into this. I love seeing Ariana Grande go into a new, fresh direction, not just for herself, but for pop music in general. And I have been excited for pop music to go into more of like a retro, almost 80s direction for a while now. And so I'm super excited to hear it being done by Ariana Grande. I can't wait until I get to hear her singing the song live. That's gonna be really, really cool. I'll be sure to do a video on that. But until then, everybody, be sure you subscribe if you're new so that you can get updates on when I do that video. Like this video if you like this video. Comment down below. Let me know what you thought about Ariana Grande's newest music video, No Tears Left to Cry. And again, check out my website, youcansinganything.com, Patreon and vlog links in the description. Peace out.